Hey guys, Christy here, DPC Technology. Today we're going to talk about encrypted email and some common questions around encrypted email. How do I send an encrypted email? How do I receive it? What does it look like on the receiving end? What if I want to send an attachment with an encrypted email? And how can I send an encrypted email from my phone? So let's jump right into the video. Okay, so now I'm going to show you how to send an encrypted email from Outlook on my desktop. So if I go onto my computer and I click new email, it's gonna pop up a new email screen. And you'll see all the options up here at the top. I am going to click options and you will see then some buttons here. There's encrypt. If I click on it, I get more options. These other options are ones we've set up internally and you can set up yourself internally, different rules on sending encrypted email, but you automatically get encrypt only and do not forward even if you don't have rules set up. So let's go ahead and say encrypt only, and you'll see a little pop-up comes up here and says, encrypt only, this message is encrypted. Recipients can't remove encryption. Permission granted, and then that's my email. So I'm gonna send that to Clay, just so you can see how it looks when it's sent. And I'm just gonna click send. And if we go to my sent box, you'll see here, there's a lock. And that's how I know it actually sent encrypted. And then I also see that same message, encrypt only, blah, blah, blah. So you see that it was sent and it's encrypted. Now I'm gonna show you what it looks like if I send it to, so Clay is inside my organization. So it looks a little bit different than if I send it to someone with like Gmail or a non-Microsoft email. So if I click it and I send to my Gmail account and I go to options again and I say encrypt, I just do encrypt only. Click send and then we'll go over to my Gmail account. Oh. Clay just responded that he got it. And you can see on his response, there's a lock too. So pretty cool. And because we're inside each other's organization and we're Microsoft, he didn't have to do some special downloading to see that. Because he's already logged into his account, it came through just fine. You'll see it's a little different on Gmail. So when I go to my Gmail account, you'll see I have the email here. It says, Christy has sent you a protected message, and there's a little lock underneath it and it'll say, read the message. So when I click read the message, it takes me to this view, which says, once again, Christy sent you a protected message, sign in to view the message. I don't have to sign in. I have two ways to sign in. I can sign in with Google or I can sign in with a one-time passcode. I'm gonna show you with a one-time passcode. So if I click there, it's gonna now email me another email with a passcode. So I have to go back to my inbox, and here's my one-time passcode. I can just copy that passcode, paste it into this other screen, and hit continue, and it's gonna bring me up to my super complex test message. And down here you can see message encrypted by Office 365 when you go to open it. And there you go, test, Christy. This message is encrypted. Recipients can't remove encryption. So that's what it looks like on the other end. It's pretty easy. You know, it's not like somebody's not gonna be able to see your email when you send it encrypted. They just have to log in and verify some steps before they can see whatever message you sent. All right, now I'm gonna show you how to send an email without using the buttons, but instead using a catchphrase. So your IT department can help set up rules on your Office 365 account that allow you to use different phrases or different rules when you're sending email. Ours that we use here is PHI in the subject, and that automatically will know to encrypt your email when you send it. So let me show you how it works. I'm gonna go to my Gmail account, and instead of going to the options, I'm gonna say test, and then I'm gonna say PHI. Now, if I go over to my Gmail account, all right, here it is. I just got that email and it says test PHI. So you know, PHI stands for protected health information. So that's why we use that catchphrase for a lot of our clients and internally. So if I click on there, I'll see Christy Thiessen has sent you a protected message. I didn't use the button, but here it is. It's encrypted. So it's like magic. If I click read the message, same thing. It's gonna go through and ask me to get a one-time password. It's gonna send me the one-time password and then I'll see that message. So pretty easy. Maybe a little skip if you don't wanna go and click the button and do all that. It's worth mentioning here that there are a couple different options when you go to send an encrypted email. I was showing you the encrypt only, but when you click on the button, there's encrypt only and do not forward, along with some other rules that we've set up internally. But do not forward means that when you send the email, it now that person that receives it can't forward it on. So, you know, it's just another layer of protection. If you are thinking of, I don't want this to go any further than that person that I'm sending it to, then use that option. Otherwise, encrypt only should be fine. All right, now I'm gonna show you what it looks like when you send an attachment in an encrypted email. It's a common question. So I'm gonna attach a PDF here that says private info, and I'm gonna go to my Gmail account. And I'm gonna say, go to options and encrypt only. I'm gonna test attach. And I'm gonna click send. And see, I get this pop-up that tells me that only file attachments that support rights management will automatically have their permission restricted to match the restrictions on this email. All other file types are attached or unprotected. Click here to learn more. So I'm gonna click OK. And then I'm gonna go over to my Gmail, back into my inbox. And see, here it is, test attach. And same thing, as you can see on this other end, I can't see that attachment or anything until I actually click into this, read the message. So it tells you it's encrypted. I'm gonna click into it and I'm gonna do a one-time passcode again. And then here's my one-time passcode. I'm gonna copy and paste that over here. Dang it, I have two open. Let's hope we pick the right one. And there it is. So now I see it says this message is encrypted, recipients can't remove encryption, and there's my PDF with all this private social security number that's fake. So that's what it looks like when you send an attachment through encrypted email. So as you can see, you can't see that attachment until you actually use that one-time passcode. Another common question is, how do I send an encrypted email from my cell phone? So a good workaround is to use those rules that I talked about earlier in the video. You do have to set those up yourself. They're not automatically set up by Microsoft, but if you have a rule where in the subject you can put something like PHI or privacy or whatever keyword you wanna use there, you just put that in the subject of your email when you're sending it from your phone, and voila, it encrypts it, just like it would if you used the button on your Outlook on your computer. So that's a little workaround. Like I said, you do have to set that up yourself. So don't yell at me if it doesn't work automatically. You do need to go in and set that up with your O365 setup at your company. Thanks for watching the video. If you had any comments or suggestions, please post them below. Also, please smash the subscribe button if this is the kind of content that you like. And we'll see you in the next video. Like you said, I'm always like just done.
Yeah.
Like, is that okay? Goodbye. Okay. I'm like talking to myself. Don't put that in there, Michael. So keep watching. Damn it, don't say keep watching.
That was good though.
Yeah, that was good.
In a nutshell. For me, an outro. All right, now I'm gonna show you from my desktop. Okay, for now, I'm gonna try to learn how to talk. And then from there, we're gonna do a video on YouTube. Bear with me. Technical difficulties.
An example is
New York.